Hello everyone, welcome to the walkthrough video. This is a demo of my calendar slash to-do list spreadsheet. If you haven't purchased the spreadsheet, I've left links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. As always, you would receive an instructions page with my information, so if you have any questions, you can go ahead and contact me through my website as well as reach out to me through Etsy. This spreadsheet comes with a comprehensive step-by-step guide that shows you exactly how to use it and how to get the best out of it. All right, we'll switch over to the demo copy so I can show you exactly how it works. All right, so right now we are in the demo copy of this spreadsheet. The first tab is your home tab. This is a hyperlink tab that would allow you navigate to the rest of the months quickly and easily. You can also change this to whatever year that you are. It doesn't affect any of the dates in the spreadsheet. This is more of a visual representation of the year that you are in. So we'll change this back to 2023. As I am making this video in December of 2023. So let's navigate to one of the tabs. Go to the January tab. By the way, using this home tab is optional because you can access the months directly at the bottom of the spreadsheet. Okay, so if you wanted to hide this home tab, you can always hide it so it's out of the way. But if you wanted to use it, you can always go back and say show home. That way you have it in front of you, can easily navigate back and forth, but again, is an optional feature. So let's go to April. We are in the April 2024 spreadsheet. Because all of this has been pre-selected for you, it comes with the year 2024. Let's say April 2025 rolls around and you wanted to use this spreadsheet. All you need to do is change this to 2025 and the entire calendar and the header changes to April 2025. The fact that it has 2024 here and April doesn't mean you can't change it. This is a completely dynamic spreadsheet. It has been preset for convenience, but when the next year rolls around, you can easily change it to whatever you want. If you want your weekday to start on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday, you can change it to whatever you want and it changes the start day of the calendar. Now, to use this spreadsheet, all you need is to add your to-do list items here. You can add up to 40 different to-do list items and add the due dates. So let's change this to reports due. And let's say this report is due April 15th. So change it to April 15th. And when we go over to that day in the calendar, you can see that we have report due April 15th, as well as another item, item number 15. So if we go here, you can see it's also due April 15. In each day, you can add 6 different items that are due. And once a task has been completed, so let's say we have completed this report, go ahead and click that box. It crosses it off the list here. So the only thing you really need to do when you get into a month is to edit the list, change the due date, and when the task is completed, you check it off. That's all you have to do because everything on the calendar side updates automatically. When you're done with the month, all you need to do is to move on to the next month that you want to work on. And again, everything has been set up. All you need to do is to adjust the weekly start day, all of your to-do list items. Once you're completed, check them off and move on to the next month. When the next year rolls around, you can use this spreadsheet over again. So you can start by changing the year to 2025. Remember, changing the year doesn't actually change any of the years here. So when I change it to 2025 and I go to the January tab, it's still 2024. I still have to change this to 2025 to bring out the calendar for 2025. But that way you have more flexibility, more control, and you can use this spreadsheet year in, year out. All right, so that is the end of this walkthrough tutorial. If you have any questions, like I said, my contact information and my website is here. You can reach me directly on my website or contact me through Etsy, and my social media links are available. And remember, you do have the step-by-step guide that will be included when you purchase this spreadsheet, so you have quick access to some frequently asked questions and how to set up your spreadsheets. Thank you so much for watching.